Hello. Today I got a suspicious looking USB charger, so I'll be reviewing it. Here it is. This is called 600 Watt GaN 3. I purchased it on AliExpress. From the model number, I suppose this charger's maximum output power is 600 watts in total. There are USB ports on this side. This USB charger is equipped with 5 USB-C ports that support USB PD and 3 USB-A ports that support quick charge. 8 ports in total. The power capacity is written for each port, and to sum up, the total amount is 600 watts. First, let's check the basic specifications. It came with a user manual. Apparently, there are different types of chargers available. This one is the top model of 600 watts. There is a similar description on the top side of the charger. There is one thing that concerns me about the description. The input voltage is from 110 volts to 240 volts, which is good, but the current is 2 amps maximum. This means that the charger can only deliver 220 watts to 480 watts at most. It started to look even more suspicious. Next, let's look at the accessories. A stand that can be set up like this. And this is the power cable. The cable on the left is the power cable that came with the charger, but it looks a bit thin for a 600 watt cable. I accidentally purchased a product that comes with an EU cable, but of course they sell products with US cables as well. Next, let's look at the price at time of purchase. The charger I purchased was about $34 on AliExpress. However, depending on the timing of the purchase, especially when there is a sale, the price fluctuates by about $7. Sometimes it is sold for around $25. Also, if you search further, you can find many similar products. Many items are sold in similar packaging. I have disassembled a charger that is similar to this one before. It's a high-power USB charger called Nexo 300 watts released by Ugreen. The selling price of the Ugreen 300 watts, which has about half the capacity, is around $120. Considering that, the one I purchased this time is a real bargain. If this charger that I purchased this time really has a capacity of 600 watts, I made a great purchase. As for the weight of the product, it's quite light for a 600 watt USB charger. Clearly, it's lighter than it's supposed to be. These power supplies tend to become heavier as their power supply capacity increases. This Ugreen 300 watt USB charger is very hefty with a substantial weight. The weight of the Ugreen 300 watt charger is 828 grams. On the other hand, the weight of the 600 watt charger purchased this time is 270 grams. It's light. I wonder if it actually achieved double power at 1/3 weight. It seems quite suspicious even before we start, but we will start experiments using the product. Firstly, as a functional test, we will check if the rated power is delivered without any issues when just one port is used. I'll use this USB PD trigger device here. By the way, I also purchased this from AliExpress. There is a link of the product in the description. Let's start by checking channel 1. Insert the trigger device like this and activate the device. I selected USB PD. Then the results appeared. It supports PD 3.1 140 watt. USB PD over 100 watt is called EPR, and this port supports EPR. It's 28 volts, 5 amps. That's not bad at all. It seems it can output 140 watts. Next is channel 2. This one is also 140 watts. Let's have a look. It supports EPR and provides 140 watts at 28 volts, 5 amps. This port also meets specs. And next is channel 3. Supports PD 3.0 at 100 watts. Channel 4. It also outputs 100 watts. And this is channel 5. This one meets specs as well at 30 watts. Based on what we've seen so far, the charger appears to deliver the specified voltage as for its USB-C ports. Next, let's look at USB-A quick charge ports. I inserted the device and it looks fine. It supports QC 3.0. The device adjusted the voltage, but it seems to be working fine. Look, it's working fine for QC 2.0 as well. This product seems pretty good. We connected the charger to an electronic load to simulate actual charging. All ports are functioning without any issues. As we have seen so far, the charger appears to deliver the specified performance when a single port is used. I don't hear any coil whine during operation. It seems surprisingly good. Next, we will look at the charger's behavior when multiple ports are used. For now, let's use the trigger device. Connected the device to channel 1. Then, the device shows this. This is the same as earlier. I have set the output voltage of channel 1 to 28 volts. Next, I want to look at channel 2. I have connected the device. Now, something has changed. From what I can see, the power available for both C1 and C2 has decreased. Individually, both channels can use 140 watts, but when you try to use both ports simultaneously, channel 1 dropped to 65 watts and channel 2 dropped to 30 watts. Let's disconnect the device from C2. Now, C1's output voltage has returned to its original value. You can use 28 volts, 5 amps, 140 watts. At this point, it seems clear that the charger cannot fully deliver 600 watts. I wonder if this means that channel 1 and channel 2 are sharing something. I believe that normally you would want channel 1 to maintain 140 watts while reducing the output power of the other channels, but that doesn't appear to be how it's operating. Next, we will see what happens when we use C3 while using C1. What happens if we unplug the cable from C2 and insert it into C3? It's working fine. C1 stays at 140 watts, while C3 seems to be able to output 30 watts. It seems that C3 can output up to 100 watts when used alone, but the power drops to 30 watts when other ports are used at the same time. Let's see if the performance meets the specs when actual loads are applied. I will try using electronic loads. The loads are connected now. C3 should output 30 watts as shown here. I'll configure the PD settings and then start applying the load. What will happen then? C3 is delivering 30 watts as expected, but C1 seems to be acting strangely. It was showing 140 watts earlier, but now it's showing 65 watts. Let's stop C3. Now EPR is on and it's delivering 140 watts, but if you start using another port, as you can see, it drops to 65 watts. This is quite an inconvenient specification. I was hoping that at least channel 1 would operate at 140 watts, but that wasn't the case. Since it decides whether to enable EPR based on the usage of other ports, it may be handling quite a bit of internal control. I also tried to operate C1 at 20 volts, 65 watts. As you can see, everything stopped working. Honestly, I don't really understand. I thought the 100 volt input might be the reason it wasn't working properly, so I got another power supply that can output 200 volts. It turns out there's no noticeable difference compared to when I used the 100 volt power supply. I read the manual that came with the charger, but it didn't say anything about how it behaves when using multiple ports. There's just so little information about the behavior of this charger, so I thought I might have overlooked something and revisited the product website. Then I found it. When you scroll down the product page and click View More, you can find pictures showing that using multiple ports at the same time reduces the total available power. I completely missed this information because I didn't bother to read this section of the product page. For a moment, I thought I'd been deceived, but on second thought, it was my fault for not reading the product page carefully before purchase. This was quite a painful mistake. After reading the details carefully, I realized that the charger cannot deliver 600 watts as stated on the product when all the ports are used. The maximum output is actually limited to 230 watts. The product name of 600W is completely misleading. It's likely not referring to the actual power rating. 600W is probably just the model number. Not long ago, there was a trend of using 2TB as a model number of SD cards and USB drives to make people think it was the actual storage capacity, leading them to buy the products. The actual capacity of such products was much smaller. They are probably aiming for the same effect for this charger. In the buyer QA section at the bottom of the product page, someone responded to a question saying that the maximum power of the charger is 215 watts, not 600. I thought AliExpress was getting better recently, but it seems that there are still such products depending on the seller. I warn you, make sure to read the product page carefully before making a purchase. From here, we will measure the power conversion efficiency and heat generation. And finally, we will proceed to disassembly. Because measuring efficiency through all the ports would be too much, I will disassemble the charger and measure efficiency straight from the internal connections, bypassing the USB ports. This is how the experiment is performed. This is the board after disassembly. I have a lot to say about it, but I will explain in detail later. These are the USB-C outputs, but they are not where I draw power from. I'm trying to directly draw power from the preceding circuit. So this is what the experiment looks like. I'll turn on the power. Let's see. The output voltage of 28.5 volts is displayed here. From here, we are going to increase the load. The current is 1 amp now. Now I'm going to increase the load. The power is currently 166 watts, but it's still working. It made a clicking sound and stopped working. When you increase the load like this, you can increase the amps up to 6 amps, but when you try to increase the load further, it stops working before reaching 7 amps. I think this is because the voltage is not 200 volts, so I'll try again after changing the voltage setting of this device. Let's try again. Here we go. It's reached 6 amps, but it stops before reaching 7 amps. It seems like it's not going to work. This is 6 amps and then 7 amps. It failed. This is totally a scam. It seems that when the power reaches around 170 watts, the protection of this USB charger is activated and the charger stops working. This product is quite disappointing. The product website says that it can handle up to around 230 watts, but in reality, it stops working due to protection when you apply 175 watts or more. By the way, these are the devices I use for efficiency measurement. These are for the output voltage and the load current. This one measures the input power. Power is provided from this AC power supply. This is the efficiency graph. The maximum efficiency was about 94%. However, there is one thing to note regarding this result. In this experiment, I measured the output power at the point, right before the circuits that adjust the voltage for each USB port. Therefore, the actual conversion efficiency will be about 1-2% lower than this data. Even considering that, the expected maximum efficiency is 92-93%, which is still quite high. In fact, the efficiency of chargers that use GaN power semiconductors is often around 91%. Considering that, this USB charger might be quite excellent, at least in terms of efficiency. Actually, the component that is heating up the most is this diode rectifier. The temperature has risen to 104 degrees Celsius, which is quite hot. This is what the backside looks like. As expected, the hottest part is the backside of the diode rectifier. It's a bit scary, so I'm going to turn off the power. After finishing all the experiments, we conducted another experiment to see if the charger can operate at rated power when multiple ports are used. We are using different trigger devices. Regarding C1, it is outputting 65 watts without any issues. However, C3 has issues. It's outputting 20 watts. It's supposed to be able to output 30 watts, so I'll try its limit. If you increase the load like this, the voltage keeps turning on and off. It's not looking good. While experimenting, the voltage output from C3 stopped. I'm not sure if you can hear this, but it's making a clicking noise. Next, let's take a look at this circuit to see what it actually does. This is the internal circuit. Some kinds of heat conduction materials are used. It looks like kneaded eraser. If you pull it like this, it comes out. What should I say? It's pretty interesting. On the backside, the same material is attached as well for heat conduction. Underneath, there's a power semiconductor. Two circuit boards are combined. I think the design of this main circuit board is solid enough. However, the amount and arrangement of the thermal silicone looks rather haphazard. The thermal conductive silicone is used, but it's not filled enough to reach this case. Since it does not come into contact with the case, I can't be sure if it provides sufficient heat dissipation. I think it's effective in terms of transmitting heat across the entire circuit board. Let's get back to the main circuit board. The circuit configuration is that of a typical conversion circuit. This is the power input. The current passes through the diode rectifier. Next, it goes through the power factor correction circuit. It's in this area of the circuit. After that, the voltage is lowered while being isolated by an LLC converter. This is the controller, and these are power semiconductor switches. On the front side, there's an inductor and a transformer. And this is a film capacitor representing the C for LLC. Then the current goes through the synchronous rectification circuit towards the USB board. The voltage at the point where it enters the USB board is fixed to 28 volts. It's set to 28 volts to align with USB PD IPR. The voltage of the USB ports can be set individually, and it's adjusted by the DC-DC converter on the USB board. It's simple since you only need to step down the voltage from 28 volts. The product name includes GaN, so I checked if gallium nitride power semiconductors are actually used. One was used in this power factor correction circuit and two were used in the LLC converter section. The manufacturer is a Chinese power semiconductor company called Corenergy. It's a vertically integrated power semiconductor manufacturer and apparently quite well known in China. If you compare to the Ugreen 300 watts charger that I disassembled the other day, the internal structures look quite different. I think you can clearly see that Ugreen makes reliable and well-designed products if you compare their product to the charger I disassembled today. So, I disassembled and reviewed this sketchy USB charger I bought on AliExpress. When I first saw this product before buying it, I already had a feeling that it was a scam. After actually buying and using it, I felt that my initial impression was correct. If you read through the product page, it does say that it cannot be used at 600 watts, but I think there are quite a few people like me who bought this product without reading the description. Also, the product page says the total wattage is 230 watts, but in reality, when the power reaches around 170 watts, it stops working. They are trying to deceive the customers regarding that too. This time, my purchase on AliExpress turned out to be quite tricky, but they have a lot of interesting gadgets that you don't get to see in Japan. And occasionally you can find good products, so I would like to continue buying various things on AliExpress. Thank you for watching.